Now, what is a preposition of time? Preposition of time, it is used to indicate the time, like when something has happened or the duration of something, duration of the festival, something like that. So in, at, on, by, for, since, etc. Now here we need to see, like, most of the time we can see, like, see the same preposition in is used in the as the preposition of place also, as the preposition of time also. Here we need to see whether it is talking about the time of something or whether it is talking about some place or it is standing for some place. So accordingly we need to decide whether it is a preposition of time or whether it is a preposition of place or position. Same with at also, same with on, by also. Now we can see when at is used, when in is used, and when on. At, Rita reached the airport at 9 p.m. So here at indicates the particular point of time, the specific point of time of that day, that is 9 p.m. We went to the temple at the beginning of this year. So here it indicates the beginning of the year. A particular point of time again. So when the specified time is given, we can use at. We met our cousins at Diwali. So here again we use like during Diwali also. Like if I want to show that span of time or the period of time, I can use during Diwali, indicating the time period for Diwali festival. That's why at Diwali. Now when in is used, men hunted animals in ancient times, so indicate the entire period of time, entire ancient period is indicated here. So if I don't want to mention the specified time, if I want to mention, you know, to show that just the period of time, I will be using in. So at refers to the particular time or the specified time, whereas in refers to that period of time. Men hunted animals in ancient times. I went to the market in the morning. So when I say in the morning, it indicates that morning time, like not the specified time in the morning. In is also used with parts of day, month, year, and season, like in the afternoon, in the evening, in winter, in autumn, in 2011. In is also used to indicate the period in which an action will take place in future. Like if I'm not sure about the action, and if I just want to show like it will happen in that time, during that time also, I can use in a week, in a month, in a few hours. On, he was born on 25th December 2000. So it indicates the date on 25th December. He met me on Monday. So here it is indicating the day. So children, we can see different prepositions of time, like during, for, by, and until. So when we use during, like see the example, I went on an adventure trip during the vacation. So here during, it is indicating a known period of time that I have already planned that vacation. So it indicates that period of time that is already known. I was alert during the match. So again, it is showing that duration of that action, duration of the match is showing here. 4. Rita slept for 2 hours. So when I say 4 here, it is showing the length of that action, length of that sleeping action, or how long Rita has slept. By, I will finish my work by 8 p.m. So here by indicates the time limit, like what is the time limit of that action. Until, he will sleep until dark. Here it is indicating again the time limit, but at the same time it also implies the continuation of that action. Okay, that is the continuation of sleeping. Now we can see the difference between and among. So we have already seen, like, you know, between, like when I say, it is also used to show the period of time only. As a preposition of time also I can use between. So when I say I was at my friend's house between 8 p.m. and 9 p.m., it is showing the time. It is showing the duration between the two points of time, with duration between 8 p.m. and 9 p.m. Within, I will complete my project within a week. So here within a week, when I use the preposition within, it is indicating the end of a certain time, ending of the certain time, within that week, ending within that period of time itself, I will be completing my action. Now what is the difference between for and since? Again, I can use for and since as a preposition of time. So when I use for, it will be showing that span of time, whereas since, I will be using since, the preposition since, to show the period, beginning of that period of time. Since indicates a point of time, the beginning of that point of time, that is when that action had started, and for indicates the period of time for which the action has been going on. So for is indicating the duration, whereas since will be indicating that beginning of that period of action. They have been traveling since Monday. So here it is showing that beginning of that action. To show that beginning of that period, I am using it since. She has been sick for a week. So here for is indicating the duration of that week. From is another, it indicates the starting point of an action. It is generally used with to or till or until. Like the exhibition will be held from 5th November to 10th November. He was secretary of the club from 2001 till 2011. So again, to show the starting point of an action, I can use from. Now this is the last one, prepositions of direction. So prepositions of direction gives us information, give us information about the direction or movement of person and things. Like remember the example that I said, when I said the dolphin dived into the sea. So it is showing the direction of that dolphin, that it has dived into the sea. The boy fell off the chair. Okay, like when I say off the chair, it is showing like he has fallen downwards. So it shows the direction of that boy, to which direction he had fallen down. So that is preposition of direction. There are many prepositions of direction or movement, like towards and to, into and in, for. So many times we can see like the same preposition can function as the time, preposition of time also, preposition of position also, preposition of direction also. According to the sense of the sentence, it will be changing its meaning. Towards, it shows the direction, and to indicates the sense of direction. Like when I say they went to the hospital, when I say they went to the hospital, it is just giving the sense of direction. It is not showing that direction, but it is giving that sense. They went to the hospital. Okay, so now when I say the car went towards the gate, so when I use the preposition towards, it is showing that direction of the car, towards the gate, the where the car is going, towards that gate, whereas to is giving only the sense of that direction. Into and in. In is often used as a preposition of place, like when I say the key is kept in the jar. So it will be used where the key, the position of the key is in the jar. So it is used as a preposition of place only. Whereas into indicates the movement towards the interior of something, like it is used as the preposition of direction. When we say like the same example, the penguin dived into the water, it shows the direction of penguin, that it has gone into the water. So in is used as the preposition of place. Into shows the movement towards the interior of something. Here the penguin is going towards the interior of the water. The girl was in the room. So when I say the girl was in the room, it is showing the place of that girl. She is positioned in the room. For, it suggests the beginning. So see, this preposition for, in the previous slide I was using it as a preposition of time, like he has been living there for a week or whatever it is, to show that duration of time. Now I can use this to show the beginning of some moment also, like father left for office just now. So it shows the beginning of the moment of father, beginning of the moment of a father, beginning of the moment. There are many more prepositions, like see, act, like conveys the idea hitting. Again, it is also used as the to show the direction or movement itself. Act conveys the idea hitting in the given hitting. Like he threw the ball at me. So it, when we use the preposition at, it shows that the ball has hit at me. Against, it shows the contact or pressure. He threw the stone against the wall. So it shows that the pressure of the wall, stone on the wall. To show the idea of hitting, we'll be using at. To show the idea of contact or pressure, we can use a preposition against. And then from indicates the point of departure. The doctor has already gone from the clinic. From the clinic, again, it is showing that point of departure. Of shows separation, like the boy fell off the chair. So when we say it shows that she fell off the bicycle, it shows that the girl has separated from that bicycle. used to indicate from the surface of or down from. Out of, just like opposite of into. Into was like something is moving into the interior of something. Here, something is going out from the interior of something. That is out of. It shows from the interior of. Okay. The other one was into the interior of. The butterfly flew out of the window. That means inside the window, it was going out. Onto indicates a movement on a particular plane. The cat jumped onto the roof of the house. That means movement on the roof of that house. Now the difference between along, through and over. Along indicates the parallel movement or side by side movement. When we say he is riding a horse along the river. So here the parallel movement, the movement of the horse along with that the flow of the river is mentioned. So side by side the movement is happening. That's why we have used the preposition along. Now through, it indicates, we use it to show the movement in a three-dimensional space like a room, a building. Preetha walked through the lobby. Okay, like from one end to another, from beginning to end. So just like that in a three-dimensional space. Over, it indicates to the other side or covering an area. He put a sheet over the sofa. He is known all over the town. To show if the ending is not known, the other side or covering area, so we will be, just to show that covering or something, we will be using the preposition over. Now there is a small topic called the objects of prepositions. So the noun phrase or a pronoun that follows the preposition is the object of preposition. Like after the preposition, the noun or the noun phrase that is coming, it will be called the object of that particular preposition. Like, see, they walked into the cafe. So here you can see like they walked into the cafe. So there is a preposition into. After that, what is the noun phrase coming? The cafe. The object is the cafe. So here the cafe is the object of the preposition into. Like we all prayed during the war. So the war is the noun that is used or the object after this preposition during. So it is the object of the preposition during. The objects of preposition answer the question what in an intransitive sentence. So normally we know like for transitive and transitive verbs, they will be answered, the objects will be answering to the question what. So here for the intransitive, in an intransitive sentence, they will be answering the question what. The preposition need not be followed by an object. Always in the assertive sentences, the preposition will be followed by the object, but in an interrogative sentence, it is not necessary that the preposition will be followed by an object. Like, who are you waiting for? Which road are you coming by? So here it is not necessary that after the preposition, there should be an object.